Thanks, Christina. Hi, everyone. My name is Dan Wahlin, and I'm really excited to have you here with us to talk about how you can integrate new or existing applications into Teams. Whether you're working with a line of business application, a software as a service app, or an entirely different category of application, you can bring your apps directly into Teams and provide a more productive way for users to get work done. To start things off, we want to help you visualize how you might take a web app that you have today and bring it into Teams. Our app is an existing customer management app that people use daily to get their jobs done. Today, this app is only available in the browser, so let's begin by taking a look at the app, and then we can see how we can make a better experience for users by integrating the app directly into Teams. So here's what our customer orders app looks like. I've already logged in through the browser using Azure Active Directory, and this particular app uses MSAL, the Microsoft Authentication Library. So now that I'm in, I can view customers in different ways, as you can see here, and I can even get to orders if I'd like. Now, in an earlier sales meeting, Burke, Holland, and I had been talking about some new customers, and Burke is new to the company, and he asked if I could put a new customer he had in mind into the system. So I said I'd do that, so let me go ahead and we'll enter Jamie Jones, I think the name was. So let me do Jamie Jones at 1234 Cedar Avenue in Phoenix, Arizona. Let me assign Jamie to Burke here. Okay, so I'll officially insert Jamie. And now what should happen is an email will go out from the app itself, and Burke should get that, and he should be good to go. Now, it looks like I got a chat, actually. So let's see. Hey, Dan, new guy here. Did you add that customer yet? Also, when do I get my bonus? Well, first off, that was uncanny timing. But hey, whatever. And hey, he's motivated on the bonus, so I want to help him out. So, Didn't you get the email? So you should have got an email that has a link to it. Let me check. Okay, let's see what he says. No, but I did get one saying I won the lottery. All I need to do is send my social security number. Yeah, definitely do that. Not. Okay, let me just say, you know, check the app because he should have the link there and be able to get to it from there. Okay, checking. Can't log in. I just changed my password and everything in my life is broken. Okay, well, that's a problem. So probably the best way to handle this is we could just jump on a Teams call. So let me go ahead and take it from there.
Hey, Dan, what's up, man? Thank you for this completely impromptu and in no way scripted Teams call. It's good to see you.
It's good to see you too. Yeah, we didn't plan this in any way, shape, or form. But how's sales going at the company for you so far?
It's been a rough morning. I don't know if you can tell.
Yeah, you can't log in, it sounds like.
I can't log into anything. In fact, the only thing I can log into is Teams, which is pretty good because that's where I spend pretty much my whole day.
Well, I mean, that's a good start. So I'll tell you what, you want me to walk you through a different option here that you can use?
Yes, please.
It's actually super productive since you said you work in Teams all the time. So first off, you were trying to get to the app. So let me show you a little bit about that. You can actually get to it right inside of Teams. If you click on Teams to the left there.
Okay.
All right. You'll notice that you're on the Wiki for General in the Learn Together sale. So it looks like you've already been there. That's great. Were you going to add to your own wiki, I guess? Is that what the plan is there?
Yeah, man. I was about to start writing that novel. Finally
awesome.
Going to get done right here in our team wiki.
That'll totally help with sales somehow. Well, anyway, see that Tailwind Trader CRM tab right up there?
Okay. Just click on that?
Yeah. Go ahead and click on that.
Hey, look at that. That's the app. I recognize that. And I saw it said I was logged in. How's that possible?
Yeah, so this is actually using single sign-on, which if you're not familiar with that, basically your Teams credentials, because you're already logged into Teams, obviously, are flowing down into the app. So you're kind of auto-logged in. And then what the developers did is they created a Teams app, and that's what this tab is here, so that we could actually embed the actual web app. So this is the app that I normally use through the browser, but I could also go through Teams just like this.
Well, that's awesome. One less password to remember. But how do I find the customer that you just put in here?
Yeah, and that's something you can do it. So if you scroll down real quick, if you page through, maybe go to the third page, you could get to Jamie there. There's Jamie right there.
There they are.
You could also filter. They're trying to work on that. But let me show you a little easier way, actually, that's kind of a new feature we have that we can use in the app in Teams.
Okay.
You want to click on chat there real quick?
Alrighty.
All right. And see that Tailwind Traders bot there?
I do, but I haven't clicked on it because, Dan, I don't interact with random robots on the internet as a general rule of thumb.
That's probably a good idea, I suspect. Go ahead. This one's safe. It was created by our dev team, so go ahead and click on it. And it looks like Jamie actually shows there.
Hey, it automatically inserted the customer here and notified me. That's pretty nice.
Yeah, so this is using something called a bot and using Azure bots combined with adaptive cards. So what you see there is a card. Let me show you a little bit about the bot. I don't know, you could type hello or howdy or type whatever you want there.
Hello, how about what is the meaning of life?
Yeah, give that a shot. I don't know if it's trained for that one, Burke, but...
Well, if it's a bot that's any good, then it's going to know the answer here. Oh, it does. Look at that. Perfect.
I think we're done here. Our work is done. I mean, is there any more you need?
Demo's over. Chip it.
So, okay. Well, that's kind of cool, but obviously you probably want to use it for a productive type thing. So go ahead and type like help.
Okay. Help.
Or help me or whatever you want.
Hey, are you lost? I'm a Tailwind Traders bot. I can help you with questions. Okay. So could I just say, get my customers here?
Yeah. Go ahead and click on that.
Oh, I see. And then it puts a chat message in and then, oh yeah. And then there's all the customers, including Jamie, the one that's just added.
Yeah.
That's pretty awesome. So I don't even have to go to the app. But Dan, look at this. Natasha's name is still misspelled. I've told him 5 times it's N-I-T, not N-A-T.
That's probably my bad. I think you did mention that in the meeting. Go ahead and click on Natasha there. And
just click on her name here?
Yeah, yeah.
But it needs to be changed in the app.
Yeah, go ahead. Just trust me. Trust me.
Oh, it took me right to her page in the app. Look at that.
So yeah, nice. Go ahead and edit Natasha here. And we'll talk about some other things this bot can do, which are kind of cool. So yeah, update that.
Just update.
Now, you might have heard a little chime there. Go back to the chat.
I did. I have a notification. I'm assuming that's the bot. Hey, look at that.
Yeah.
Updated customer. Her name is finally spelled correctly. Look at me already adding value here at Tailwind Traders.
Exactly. So you've kind of seen how the bots allow you to communicate. And not only can they show these adaptive cards in different ways of communicating through the app or even typing, but as you typed, like the meaning of life, that was actually calling into Cognitive Services, which is an Azure service, and using something called Lewis and Q&A. So the developers in the company, I guess they just really customized the Lewis and the Q&A stuff so that we can go in and do these types of activities.
A bot with artificial intelligence. What a time to be alive. But cool. Dan, I don't spend most of my day on my computer. I spend most of my day on my phone. Can I still talk with the bot there?
You can. You can. In fact, do you have Teams installed on your mobile app?
I do. And in fact, believe it or not, I have it running and mirrored to my screen because that's just what I do every day.
Is that just how you roll?
It is. All right. So here's my phone coincidentally mirrored to my screen and sized perfectly for a screen recording. Just happens to be. So what do I do here? I just interact with the bot?
You could interact with the bot if you wanted, yeah. Or if you click on Teams again.
Okay.
And then scroll on down back to that general channel. And click on More.
More.
And there you go. Tailwind Trader CRM. Go ahead and give that a shot. And this should load the app for you.
Oh, I can access the app directly on my phone. How does that? But I didn't even install anything from the App Store. It's just there?
It is. It is. It's part of the Teams app that I mentioned earlier with the tab that developers can add. That just automatically carries forward to wherever you're running Teams. So it could be Teams in the browser, Teams on desktop, Teams in mobile. You can get to it pretty much anywhere.
And I didn't even have to sign in. Clearly my favorite part.
Exactly. no passwords to memorize and all of that type of stuff. Very cool. We've only scratched the surface with what's possible as you bring your app into Teams, but you've seen that there's some very unique opportunities you could take advantage of as a developer and enhance the productivity of your users. And these are things that really you can only do if you bring your app into Teams. So to wrap things up, Burke, let's do a real quick recap of what we've gone through in this demonstration.
Okay.
So first off, we talked about how once your app is in Teams, you can leverage single sign-on, and that means the users can just be logged into Teams and they're ready to go. Now, I know if we switch back to your sales role, Burke, that was kind of a big deal, right?
Yes, as a salesperson, I found it extremely convenient that I don't have to log into yet another system. If I'm logged into Teams, I'm automatically logged into the app. And even better than that was the fact that we were able to interact with the data via a bot. And that bot can understand what I'm saying naturally because of Azure Cognitive Services like Lewis, which is natural language processing, and Azure Q&A Maker, which is what allows us to get to the data in the application from the bot. And better yet, now we know the meaning to life.
Very important, very important. And then finally, we talked about how once you have integrated your app into Teams, users can get to it through Teams on the desktop, in the browser, or even on mobile, and they don't have to install any additional download other than the Teams app itself. So it makes kind of a one-stop shop, you could say, to get to everything that the users need.
Yeah, absolutely. Now, I got to be honest, Dan, all this seems kind of magical. So how do we know this isn't all just smoke and mirrors? Code or it didn't happen is what I'm saying.
That's right. Well, fortunately, if you're interested in getting to the code for this and the setup procedures involved with it, you can go to the GitHub link that you see on your screen, and that will have everything you need for the application that Burke and I walked through.
Nice.
So with that, let me go ahead and turn things over to Christina.